bots to extract features with which then the machine learning algorithms can work with. The automated extraction features enables us to work with larger and larger data sets, removing the human completely, except from the supervision labeling step at the very end. It doesn't require the human expert. But at the same time, there is limits to our technologies. There's always a balance between excitement and disillusionment. The Gartner hype cycle, as much as we don't like to think about it, applies to almost every single technology. Of course, the magnitude of the peaks and the droughts is different. But I would say we're at the peak of inflated expectation with deep learning. And that's something we have to think about as we talk about some of the ideas and the exciting possibilities of the future. And with self-driving cars that we'll talk about in the future lectures in this course, we're at the same. In fact, we're a little bit beyond the peak. And so it's up to us. This is MIT and the engineers and the people working on this in the world to carry us through the drought, to carry us through the future as the ups and downs of the excitement progresses
sir,
forward.
Taco Bell's new loaded taco fries. Loaded with the most taco topping toppings ever. It's a lot to load. Only at Taco Bell.
Into the plateau of productivity. Why else not deep learning? If we look at real-world applications, especially with humanoid robotics, robotic manipulation, and even, yes, autonomous vehicles, majority of the aspects of autonomous vehicles do not involve to an extensive amount machine learning to date. The problems are not formulated as data-driven learning. Instead, they're model-based optimization methods that don't learn from data over time. And then from the speakers these couple of weeks, we'll get to see how much machine learning is starting to creep in. But an example shown here with the Boston, with amazing humanoid robotics from Boston Dynamics. To date, almost no machine learning has been used except for trivial perception. The same with autonomous vehicles. Almost no machine learning and deep learning has been used except with perception, some aspect of enhanced perception from the visual texture information. Plus, what's starting to be used a little bit more is the use of recurring